Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Hayden Raven, and welcome to Blackout. Now, Blackout is a survival game, and it's about what happens when the world loses electricity. Now, this is, in fact, one of the most popularized apocalyptic post-era games, which is very, very interesting, because it gives us a lot of information about what happens when we lose control. So, ladies and gentlemen, join me this evening as we figure out what Blackout holds for us in amongst all the darkness. It was a short moment, just a blink of an eye. The bright light burst across the horizon, expanded over night sky like a burning wave. With incredible speed, it quickly spread to every corner of the earth, frying every electric circuit, every transistor, and every chipset. The known world was engulfed by darkness. Thousands of disasters laid low whole cities and turned our civilization into dust. Those who couldn't adjust to living as this new world quickly died out of diseases, starvation, or in fighting. Only a few remained left. These people witnessed a miracle. One night, the pitch-black horizon became enlightened by bright flashes of artificial light. It may have looked like an illusion of some. Others took it for a bad omen and crowded in awe in their shelters. However, the majority of survivors believed this to be a sign of hope. In a form of a new civilization, without hesitation, those people formed groups which had only purpose to reach the mysterious brightness. Your goal is to lead one of these groups to the destination, yet you have to make haste. It is said that the mystical source of light may vanish at any moment. Will your group manage to get to safety, or will it be engulfed by the dying world? The one thing that is certain, it is you who needs to lead them. So, do we get a character choice? What is this? No, we do not. Okay. The black surface of cracked road vanishes in the thick morning fog. The omnipresent silence fills the minds in fear and hope alike. This is where our journey begins. Let's see for what waits on the trail. Let's start our journey. Let's see what awaits us on our trail. Okay, yes, I'm going to be smart about this. The road stretches out across... Oh my goodness, I just realized the sun just went up in that waiting time. I need to be hasty then. The road stretches out across the horizon, calling us to take up the journey. Yet we may look around surroundings to try to find places worth searching. What should we do? Well, it looks like everybody's mediumly, statistically fine. What is our best option? Sergey, don't you want to suggest something? And what is your opinion? Okay, so I am making these choices. All of these people are with me. Let's make a decision. Sarah says we should send Sarah to scout ahead. She may find something interesting in the fog. Well, I think that's a bad idea. I think she'll get ambushed by whatever's waiting for her out there. We should carry on going forward. We have to cover as much distance as possible. I agree with that one. We need to move on, but try to conserve our strength at the same time. Slower march will let us be more aware of unexpected dangers ahead. Now that is my option. We set out with a regular pace, carefully watching the road ahead. The journey will probably make us tired, but we should still have enough strength remaining. Get to our destination safe and sound is all that matters. This is true. While watching the road, we spotted a group of people in the distance coming our way. The strangers haven't seen us yet. What should we do? We should stay hidden. We can't take unnecessary risks. That is smart. We should reveal our presence. They might have some goods to trade with us. Maybe, probably not. I still don't trust that. We should wait and see what they're up to. It will be easier to do it from a closer range. We should hide and wait until they pass us unnoticed. I'm gonna be skeptical, and we tried to spot more details, but the wanderers realized are being watched and quickly turned the other way after a few moments that they were gone. Maybe it's for the best. This is true. We spotted a lonely woman in the distance who immediately ran towards us. She begged us to help her sick daughter whose condition has been getting worse for a few days. It appears that she needs some meds and food. There's nobody protecting her. Let's take her stuff. Let's not do that. It's not our business. We can just give our ways. We should help her. Even in times like this, people should help one another. Oh, this is bad. I'm gonna do the right thing, though, and that's to help. The woman thanked us very much and hugged each one of us. We lit a spark of hope in her eyes. Good karma always comes back. One day, we may be in need. So, it seems that Sarah and Sergey are very happy, but Sergey is very hungry. We came across an obstacle. Our way is separated by a fast flowing river, and a nearby bridge collapsed some time ago. What should we do? Let's try to swim the other side. The current is much too strong, I guarantee you that. The only solution is to go around and find another crossing to the other side. Let's send Sarah to scout in the most shallow spot so we can cross the river. Why do we keep sending Sarah out to do all this mess, huh? Oh my, this is not going to end well. The only solution... Oh my, I just realized, each option has a certain effect on their stats, I'm sorry. So this is very interesting. I'll send Sarah just because I do indeed need to send Sarah. Sarah manages to find a shallow spot in a few minutes. It's good that we have someone like Sarah in our team. Sergey, can I help you? Can I feed you? Can I give anybody some help? When the early sun rays broke through the morning mist, high shapes of city buildings emerged on the horizon. Let's find out what awaits us. Once teeming with life, the metropolis now appears to be dead and unnaturally silent. As we approach closer, we notice the derelict tenants and deserted blocks of flats. What awaits us here? And what are your thoughts? Sarah, what do you think about it? I'm gonna ask Sergey because he is hungry. In the dense thicket on the sidelines, we spotted a small campsite where there wasn't any people present, but we could see smoke coming from the dying campfire. Let's not risk unnecessarily. We should move on. Perhaps there's some supplies, and we need some. Especially... Yeah, Sergey, you good. We got closer to the campsite. There's nobody there, but we found some fresh fruit. Should we search the nearby tent? Let's search it. We found a lot of canned food and some meds in those tents. In the meantime, came the inhabitants. Those brutal thugs don't look happy about us being here. Let's attack them. We need these supplies. Let's give them back their stuff. Maybe they will leave us alone. I would say give them back their stuff. They don't look too happy. We gave back their supplies, they let us go. This time we got away with it. Let's hit the road. Oh, that's not good though. On the way, we encountered an elderly man searching through car wrecks. He was very frightened when he saw us and even put his hands up asking not to hurt him. Let's bypass the guy and move on. Let's talk to him. We might get some information. We need his supplies. Let's take his stuff. I'm not gonna rob the guy. The old guy was very distrustful, but eventually exchanged a few words. He told us that he's been living in this area for all his life, and that he doesn't want to leave, even though it's getting harder to find any supplies. At the end of our conversation, he showed us a hidden path where we'll definitely shorten our journey. We have to move on. The shortcut will save us a lot of time. Suddenly, a pack of hungry dogs runs out of nearby bushes. Those beasts' teeth are dripping with saliva. They're all around us. Let's try to run away, but stick together. I do fear that you're going to lose very much health if you do that. Let's... Sergey, try to chase them away. Sarah, notice a nearby building in which we could take shelter. Let's run there. Let's throw them some food and try to back away slowly. We don't have food, so I'm going to go with Sarah. We managed to take shelter in the building. It took some time for the dogs to leave us alone. At least we're safe. Good job, Sarah. Let's hit the road now. Sarah, you're doing a whole lot of work. Good job. Oh. It appears that we've lost Sergey. Sergey couldn't deal with malnutrition. When we made a brief stop, he took most of supplies and decided to leave. Nobody could stop him. We should have given him more food. We will have a harder time without him. Well, geez. Anne, you look like you might have some food. Share, I guess. I don't know. Our trek is interrupted by a distant gunshot. Should we follow them? It's not our business. We shouldn't. We need to check it out. Let's follow the source of the sounds. Let Sarah scout ahead. Sarah, you go ahead, girl. You've been good thus far. The sound of gunshots intensified with every minute until we finally saw a little bit of a nearby slope. Sarah reported that the gunshots were coming from bandits attacking some survivors in the buildings. She really wanted to help those poor people. There's no need for unnecessary risk. You see, I don't believe that we have guns, and we're already really low on stuff, so we can't even help. The bandits killed all survivors just before our eyes. Afterwards, they scavenged the bodies, taking supplies, equipment, and even clothes. Soon after, they disappeared in the ruins, leaving only mutilated corpses behind. We could have helped them, but there's too much risk involved. There are a few blood-stained bodies in the middle of the road. Most of these corpses have been scavenged, but it appears that they still may have some valuables on them. What should we do? I'm gonna say leave them alone, despite the need for supplies. May they rest in peace. That's messed up. When the whole area was covered with impenetrable darkness, we decided to set up a campsite in this secluded place among the ruins. We managed to rest and talk about past day experience. Sarah, what's your opinion about the journey? We should set up sentries just in case. We'll do regular turns. This is good. When the first sun rays began to dominate over the horizon, we started to get ready for our trek. After a short while, we gathered our gear and hit the road. There's a long way ahead of us. We shouldn't linger anymore. Let's hope fate will be kind. We heard a hushed shouting from the distant ruins. It sounded like somebody was calling for help. Should we react? In the campsite, it's safe. Someone needs to help. We should check it out. The shouting may herald trouble. We should leave immediately. You see, I feel my gut instinct says this is a trap, so I'm gonna try to help. Moving fast, we headed towards the screams and into the ruins. After a while, we saw a pack of wolves attacking a frightened man. The beast ran away, scared by her sudden appearance. However, the man was badly wounded. Let's check on him. The man has several bites around his neck, left shoulder. It seems that he will bleed out in any moment. Oh, Sergei. You see, Sergei. This is a very interesting mechanic because Sergei is, despite gone, Sergei would have put him out of his misery, whereas Anne and Sarah could not or would not. So it's very interesting that they've decided to do this. Leave him in this place now. Let's try to dress his wounds. We used a lot of our medical supplies but couldn't stop the bleeding completely. However, we managed to stop it enough so the man could tell us something. Let's listen to what he has to say. I beg you, if you're heading towards the brightness, not far from here, you will bump into my house. You'll know it's mine, the big fan in front of the porch. You have to. He passed out. Let's try to revive him gently. We don't have time to listen on to his confession. We should move on. We've got some time. My daughter is in that house. There is a hidden safe in my cabinet behind the old painting. My daughter doesn't know about it. There's some canned food there. Please give it to her. Let's ask the safe code. Remember, left, right, left. That's the combination. Please give her and tell her how much I love her. I think he's dead. His breathing suddenly stopped and the lifeless body became stiff. It's high time we hit the road. We should try to find his house. We spotted the house with the big fan. That's exactly how the man described it. Let's pass by it. Let's go inside. There was nobody inside. It looked like somebody took all valuable things and left in a hurry. Let's check the attic. The attic, we found a letter on the floor. Dad, you're not coming back for 2 days. That's why Uncle Mark is taking me to his place. We hope to meet you there. That's sad. Behind the old and stained painting, we found the safe. It looks pretty old. There's a knob on the front. Let's leave the safe intact. We need to move on. Let's try to open the door. It was left, right, left. We need to give the proper sequence by turning the knob right and left. Should we try to jerk the door and see if the sequence worked? Left. Right. Left. Behind it, we found a lot of provisions. They will surely help us on our way. Oh, wow, that's a lot of food. Okay, then. Fantastic. We leave the ruined city and after a long trek found ourselves in the wastelands again. Before our eyes, there was heavy rusted information on board showing us the way to the brightness. It's not far. We just have to go a little further. Realizing that the distance is getting much shorter, with each day we all feel at ease. It's time for a bit of happiness. Let's walk some more since we still feel motivated. Let's set up a campsite here and regain our strength. We're actually pretty good on everything, so let's keep moving. Did you hear that? Being in good humors, we almost don't hear the commotion coming from the nearby thicket. What could it be? We then realize it's coming. It's already too late. Prepare yourselves. Suddenly, dark silhouettes emerge from the nearby thicket. The attackers start to encircle us, and one of them takes out a pistol from his side pocket. He's pointing it at us. What shall we do? talk. Find out more by playing the full version of the game, Blackout. Thank you for the trial game. Let us know what to do and what you think. We survived for now. You win. You survived after 63 kilometers. You finished first part of the journey to brightness. Wow, this is very cool. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm afraid we've come to the end of our time with Blackout. This apparently was a demo, not to my knowledge, and I'm very interested by it. I hope I can get the full version in my hands, and by that time, I really hope that I'm able to figure out what happens at the brightness. So ladies and gentlemen, this is a wonderful game, and I hope that you download it for yourself. But we have reached the end of our time. Join me next time and see what kind of post-apocalyptic, strange survival adventure that we can get ourselves into. For now, I must bid you a good evening and a good night. I'll see you.